Celebrity TV, DJ Lewin, team of niggas that broke now, get me seen, Havilland, Cielo, Consulin, Jackson, and Petrician, come here, Celebrity TV, we are wow.
Money, me, because you're seeing out the system. Yo, you're watching Celebrity TV live. This is Shatta Wale Bandana.
Hello, lovely viewers. We have something special for you this week. Just get close to your TV set and take a nice selfie as the show goes on, and then post it on our celebrity fan page on Facebook. We'll then show as many photos as we can in next week's episode. Let's create some small fame for ourselves too. Well, that was just by the way. On Celebrity TV today, Kobna Kobna Jab Obor and his team and calls them toothless. Rosalind Ngizo says, they're not like my style. Most Ghana celebrities live a fake life. They have fame without money. Delay says so, and Alabaster Bus makes Ghana proud on BBC. We'll also find out who says, I don't like poor men admiring me. Last week, it was Crystal Okoye who was saying, her type of guy must be strong, good and capable in bed. Sakara. And on the international front, BET and Viacom sued over shooting at BET Awards after party. You're officially welcome to Celebrity TV. We're gonna go for a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we'll delve into the stories. We'll be right back after the break. My name is Gail.
Watching Celebrity TV.
We love them, we love them.
You stay tuned, you Celebrity TV.
Celebrity TV, TV. Celebrity TV.
Celebrity TV.
Celebrity TV.
Watching Celebrity TV.
Celebrity TV.
Celebrity TV.
Celebrity TV.
Number one.
Celebrity TV, TV.
If it's hot, they got it, they make it rock.
Do you need a Blackmagic cinema camera to rent? The Blackmagic cinema camera features an amazing 2.5K image sensor with a wide 13 stops of dynamic range for a true digital film camera. The Blackmagic cinema camera also features a high resolution sensor with wide dynamic range, so it's perfect for independent film, music videos, television commercials, TV series, etc. We rent out the Blackmagic cinema camera fully rigged with a Canon 17-55mm EF zoom lens and Canon 50mm prime lens, two SanDisk super state drives, an extra power base battery pack, the professional A-Box XLR audio adapter. Rent a Blackmagic cinema camera today and work at the highest quality to achieve the best results.
This is Valerie. I'll be coming up with the latest entertainment news from New York, the Big Apple, the city that never sleeps. We have a lot of news coming up to you on Celebrity TV. Keep watching.
Welcome back, everyone. You're still tuned to Celebrity TV, and thanks for staying with us. Now, starting off, Kobna Kobna has told eNewsGhana.com what he feels is wrong with the current musical setup headed by fellow musician Baizo Sekupor Obuo. There is no industry, he says. It is crazy when you are an artist and you talk like this, and people take it from the music politics point of view. I don't have any interest in going near any music politics because I have about 15 years of active music in me and I still want to pursue. But there are certain people who should make sure whatever we create yield benefits to us, and these are the people in the helm of affairs. The people managing the structures don't even understand what they are doing. I don't mean to criticize anyone, but these guys are not doing great as long as far as governing the music industry is concerned. Asked any musician what they get from doing a hit record apart from being famous and being called a musician. So if you have a leader and he's not thinking about putting money in the pocket of the hit maker, then what are we doing as a group? It's simple. You ask yourself what the other developed countries are doing to put money in their artists' pockets. Why wouldn't you consult their expertise? I heard 2 million Ghana cedis was given to a company to check our contribution to the nation's GDP. How does that benefit the musician? Put money in the musician's pocket through his work. If I had 2 million, I would go to the UK and consult them on how they collect the revenues for the work the musicians do. Buy the software that will monitor the systems for us. Then seek the government to help us make it mandatory for every media outlet to be on that monitoring scheme. And it looks like Pabna Pabna is not the only one worried about music not doing so well, but also Guru. On hanging out with KLD last week, Guru also vented his anger on Musica about artist royalty and the need for them to do more. Plus-size actress Rosalind Ngiza has told News One that she no longer struggles for movie roles in Ghana's movie industry. According to her, she has become a force to reckon with, and the industry has no choice but to give her talents and skills a chance. Until now, the four-play actress used to be one of the few plus-size actresses in the industry who used to struggle to get roles and get noticed. Her days of size discrimination are long gone, as more attention is given her talent than her God-given stature. Now that I have climbed the ladder, I don't have issues with roles and my size, because before any filmmaker calls me, he or she writes a character that fits me. For now, I can say my size is a problem. It was when I was rising as a newcomer that was when I had problems, she added. A co-winner for Best Actress at the 2010 Ghana Movie Awards, Rosalind is also a graduate of the University of Ghana School of Performing Arts. She is best known for her roles in Reckless, Broadway, I Stand Accused, Princess Tyra, Power of the Gods, Last Victory, My Sister's Anna, Sin of the Soul, A Sting in the Tail, and Adam's Apple. Indeed, Rosalind has proven herself as one of the promising actresses in Ghana's contemporary movie industry, possessing a natural flair for acting. Go Rosalind, plus size or no plus size, you're going higher and higher.
Celebrating TV. Celebrating TV.
TV host and radio presenter Delores Frimpong-Mansu, best known as Delay, has said she will settle for money anytime and any day when asked to choose between money and fame, saying fame without money makes you live a fake life. I don't eat pain. Money talks. It makes the world go round. She was speaking to News One over speculations that she was desperate to remain in the top league of famous Guinean celebs after her fame started dwindling last year. Maybe you're saying so because I have stopped painting my hair in blue and cruising in flashy cars to shows and posing for the cameras. As you grow in the showbiz stuff, you get to realize that fame on its own is not the most important thing. It can neither buy kinky nor land. When maturity starts to set in, you focus more on the business part of the creative art industry rather than the show aspect. She continued, I don't want to be a famous celebrity who depends on salary from my boss or whose source of living is dependent on how much a director decides to pay me for a role. I have gone past that stage. I want to be an independent woman, an entrepreneur who employs people and pays them salaries. I want to be real, so when I step out, I don't fake my status and pretend to belong when indeed I am in someone's pocket. That is when I would be worth celebrating, but not what we have in this country where we celebrate people simply because they have worn an extravagant attire or because they are driving a second-hand Range Rover and pretended it is customized-made. I don't have money yet, but I'm still getting there because I'm working very hard at it. The concept of celebrities in Ghana is a mirage, and the higher you climb, the more you realize the whole concept is a make-believe, Delay explained. Delay presents the mid-morning show on Oman FM. She is the director and executive producer of the Fia Schwarzenegger TV series and host of the Delay talk show on Bastard One. Furthermore, she owns the franchise to distribute the Delay mackerel in Ghana and Africa, and also owns a couple of shops where she sells clothes, shoes, and bags. We must begin to think along these lines, so we invest our money into businesses that can fetch us more money, rather than waste our money competing among ourselves on who has the flashiest car, or who has the longest hair, or the best on skin, Delay added. Ghana's award-winning and leading gospel a cappella music quartet, Alabaster Box, made a surprising appearance on the world-acclaimed BBC Focus on Africa on BBC World TV. The group was the first ever gospel music act and the first Ghanaian group to have made an appearance on the show since its inception at the massive BBC broadcasting house in London. Alabaster Box was in the UK on the invitation of Jesus House London, and also to tour several other churches across a number of cities in the UK. Group leader Samuel Douna, who is also news editor of Multimedia's Adam FM, said, "We were originally billed to appear on BBC Focus on Africa on radio, but after the recording of radio interviews with Akwesasapon, we took a stroll to the TV section where we met the new host of Focus on Africa TV show, Sophie Ikenya, and she insisted we did TV as well. Alabaster Box rocked the show with their unique form of a cappella nicknamed Afropella, creating mouth made beat of purely indigenous African instruments accompanied by African harmonies to deliver gospel music."
CJ Multimedia Film Training Center is offering a 13-week intensive training morning and evening in the following areas of specialties: film acting, video editing, film directing, film photography, sound engineering. Successful applicants will feature in movies, TV series and documentaries as part of their training package. Pick up the registration form for 30 Ghana cedis and get a brochure with comprehensive details of courses. Register now. Registration is in progress. Register now and develop your potentials into stardom. For more information, call 024-689-2408 or 020-815-4498. Locate CJ Multimedia at Abekala Pass behind ADB.
Welcome back, and you're still watching Celebrity TV. Ghanaian music star Trigmatic says he seeks to propel change in the Ghanaian society through his music. To this end, he is consciously shifting from the very youthful music he is known for towards more matured lyrics. The award-winning musician said in an interview he feels the need for change. He believes his lyrical orientation has changed because he is growing and naturally thinking a lot about making his songs stand the test of time. He says it has gotten to a point where you are unable to wear the things you used to wear or visit the places you hitherto frequented. I feel everything must change. It means a change in lyrics, more live performances, every part of the art must grow. The whole Ghana needs to change. Trigmatic's song Usikanti has received 3 nominations at the forthcoming Ghana Music Awards, and the young musician says the nominations excite him and makes him feel appreciated. He has been nominated for the Songwriter of the Year, Record of the Year, and Collaboration of the Year. He thanked his fans for remaining loyal despite the changes he is exhibiting. The self-acclaimed Coco Master, Dapo Oyebanjo, popularly known as Dibanj, has expressed his readiness to walk down the aisle very soon. few years ago, it was reported that the energetic singer would pick a lady as a wife after it was earlier rumored that his mother kicked against his purported affair with Genevieve Naji, a Nollywood star. The 34-year-old music star is no doubt a hot cake to ladies who would be glad to be DeBange's wife or be called Mrs. DeBange. At the traditional wedding ceremony of Paul Okoye of Peace Square and Anita Isama, which took place in Port Harcourt, Rivers State on Saturday, March 23, 2014, the Ija in-law disclosed that he would now consider selling down just like Paul. He made this disclosure while performing at the event. He hailed Paul for taking the bold step to marry his heartthrob and revealed thereafter that he is inspired by this, which has made him to start looking in that direction. Paul has now become a married man. Congratulations, bro. You have now inspired me to think about marriage. I'll marry soon, DeBange said. His colleague, Frankie W., Peter Okoye Final, who were also at the event, hailed his decision to pick a woman as his wife. Nollywood actress Lizzie Gold says the major criteria for any man to woo her is that must be rich, and that no poor man should even think of admiring her picture, let alone toast her. In a recent chat with Entertainment Express, Lizzie also said bank alerts turn her on. A poor man shouldn't even think of admiring my picture, not to talk of wooing me. I love money so much so I can't marry a poor man. I don't even want a man who is merely comfortable. My interest and affection are for millionaires, if possible, billionaires. Money means so much to me. In fact, money makes me wet. Sometimes when I imagine so much money in my account, I could just get wet. Bank alert is like my best friend. I just need to imagine so much money in my account and I'm turned on. When I get a credit alert on my account, oh my God, I get turned on immediately. Lizzie says aside having money and being willing to spend it on her, another very important thing she looks out for in a man is that he must be well endowed. So we're just thinking, all this from somebody's future wife? What if the rich man falls on bad times? End of marriage, I guess. Women are appreciated more when they don't base their success on others. After all, you have the same opportunity. So why don't you create wealth and be as wealthy as you want to be? Coming up today on our Celebrity TV Personality of the Week, we are revealing one of the hottest actors GH has ever produced, Majid Michelle. Majid Michelle, born September 22, 1980, is a Ghanaian actor. He received nominations for Best Actor in a Leading Role at the Africa Movie Academy Awards in 2009, 2010, 2011 and 2012. He eventually won the awards in 2012 after three previous consecutive nominations. Majid was born in Cantonment, a suburb of the Ghanaian capital, Accra. The son of a Lebanese father and a Ghanaian mother, Majid grew up in Accra with his nine siblings. He attended St. Teresa's Primary School and later the Mfantsipim School in Cape Coast. In secondary school, Majid was actively involved in theater and was a member of the school's drama club. As a member of the drama club, Majid received a Best Actor Award in one of their performances on Emancipation Day in Cape Coast, Ghana. Majid entered professional acting by chance. He was invited to join the modeling agency, Supermodel Agency, on the behest of his next-door neighbor. He starred in Things We Do for Love. Majid acquired his nickname Shaker on the set. His role on Things We Do for Love was to be played by a Lebanese boy, and Majid attributes his acquiring the role to his Lebanese heritage. Things We Do for Love became a success and propelled Majid into the mainstream. On the strength of his performance in Things We Do for Love, Majid was cast in his first movie, Divine Love, as the male lead, alongside Jackie Appiah as the female lead and Van Vicker in a supporting role. All three used the
I'm not going to be able to do that.